ForceField Weather Barrier System from Georgia Pacific consists of engineered wood panels with an enhanced overlay and accessories that help achieve an air and water-resistive barrier. The engineered wood panels meet the roof underlayment requirements set forth in IBC Section 1507.1.1 and IRC Section R905.1.1. When multiple layers of underlayment are required, the ForceField Weather Barrier System may replace only the first layer. In this video, we'll showcase common installation techniques using the ForceField Weather Barrier System. Before starting any construction project, keep safety top of mind. Remember to wear the proper personal protective equipment, PPE, and take the appropriate steps for fall protection while on the roof. For this installation, you'll need the following tools: a tape measure, cutting tool like a knife, saw, T-square or straight edge, chalk line, J-roller, pneumatic nail gun and airline regulators, flush drive adapters for nail guns, and an air compressor. For proper storage and to assure optimum performance, ForceField panels must be stored and handled properly. Adhering to the guidelines found in the ForceField installation instructions will help protect panels from damage in storage, during shipment, and on the job site. When cutting the panel, set the saw blade to the proper depth to cut completely through the panel. Take precaution not to cut the panel below if cutting on top of other panels. ForceField Weather Barrier System should be used only on sloped roofs with a 212 pitch or greater. When installing the panels, the gray weather barrier side must be facing out. Install the panel so that the long direction, 8-foot side, is perpendicular to the roof trusses or rafters and spans a minimum of 3 supports. The short edge, 4-foot side, of the panel should be located over a framing member and staggered a minimum of 24 inches from the adjacent panels. Spacing of 1/8 inch between the panels should be maintained at all edges and end joints. Unsupported 7/16 inch panels spanning more than 16 inches on center require additional blocking, or H-clips may be installed midway between panels. ForceField panels should be attached to the roof trusses or rafters per project specifications and all applicable local codes, and must meet the following minimum requirements. Use a minimum of 8D common nail spaced 6 inches on center along panel edges and 12 inches on center at intermediate supports. Fasteners must be placed a minimum of 3/8 of an inch from all panel edges. If pneumatic nail guns are used, be sure to set air pressure to drive nail heads flush or a maximum 1/16 inch below the panel surface. For best performance, immediate sealing of joints with ForceField premium tape is recommended. To tape the panel seams, ensure the surface is free from moisture, frost, dust, dirt, and other bond-inhibiting materials. Remove the liner and center the ForceField premium tape over the roof panel seam. Apply firm pressure on the ForceField premium tape with your hand to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved. As a best practice, use a J-roller to roll over the tape after hand application to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. At T-joints and where tape splices occur, overlap a minimum of 2 inches. Sequence tape application such that a shingle lap application is achieved. H-clips must be taped using ForceField premium tape. Center the tape over the H-clip to ensure it is covered. Apply adequate pressure on all sides of the clip using your hand or J-roller. To temporarily dry in your building, install ForceField premium tape over the ridge seam. Start by centering the ForceField premium tape over the ridge seam. Apply firm pressure on the tape surface with your hand or a J-roller to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the surfaces and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. Prior to installing the ridge vent or roof covering, it is important to cut or remove the ForceField premium tape on the ridge seam to allow for proper ventilation. Where the roof intersects with a wall, chimney, or dormer, center the ForceField premium tape over the transition seam between the roof and the wall. Install metal flashing at the roof-to-wall transition per project design or local building code. Apply ForceField Seam Tape Plus or ForceField Premium Tape to the top edge of the installed metal flashing and a minimum 2 inches onto the wall panel. The applied tape should cover all flush-driven fasteners used to attach the flashing and a minimum of 2 inches onto the panel face. If more than one piece of tape is needed to achieve proper coverage, a shingle lap application of the tape must be used. Finish by applying ForceField Premium Tape to the bottom edge of the metal flashing and onto the ForceField panel, covering all flush-driven fasteners used to attach the metal flashing, and by maintaining a minimum of 2 inches onto the face of the roofing panel. Apply firm pressure on all the tape surfaces with your hand or a J-roller to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the surfaces and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. For roof valleys, follow the roof system manufacturer's requirements and local building codes. Using ForceField Premium Tape, center the tape over the valley seam where the ForceField panels join. When installing metal flashing, position metal flashing over the installed ForceField Premium Tape per the project technical documentation and local building code and the roof manufacturer's requirements. Apply ForceField Premium Tape over the edges of the installed metal flashing a minimum of 2 inches onto the flashing and ForceField panel face. If fasteners were used to secure or attach the flashing, the installed ForceField Premium Tape must cover all flush-driven fasteners. If more than one piece of tape is needed to achieve proper coverage and to cover flush-driven fasteners, a shingle lap application of the tape must be used. Apply firm pressure on all of the tape surfaces with your hand or a J-roller to ensure that a continuous bond is achieved between the tape and the surfaces and to eliminate wrinkles and air bubbles. For more information on ForceField Weather Barrier System, please visit gpforcefield.com.